What's going on, Geekdom? This is Chipmunk doing another reaction. We are doing a top 10. This is top 10 most anticipated new anime of 2022 from ViniiTube's channel. Check out ViniiTube in the descriptions below. The link to their channel is in there in the description. So check them out. I'm guessing like the last time, because I've done a reaction for ViniiTube before. When they did most anticipated. Most anticipated anime ended up being mostly sequels and stuff like that. So I'm guessing that he was wanting to do something different, not focus heavily on that, because it was a lot of sequels. Yes, we love sequels. We do love sequels. We anticipate sequels a lot, but new anime is hardly seen, and I like to see what is coming out. So hopefully he'll show something that I'm not familiar with this is coming out that I would love to see or probably check out. So, the same for y'all. Hopefully, the same for y'all. Let's go ahead and check this out and see what he put on his top 10.
Chunibyo, 8th grader syndrome. Those words quickly conjure up images in your mind, perhaps of a time past that you feel
shame
looking back
at. Not at all.
Perhaps of that one classmate of yours that you just don't get. Perhaps you're all just like Sid Gargano once, drowning in imaginations and dreaming of being the mastermind behind heroes and villains. Reborn as a noble in a world of magic after a mandatory visit from Drakkon, Sid seeks to put his dreams to the test. Having dames and recruiting members to his organization Shadow Garden, he looks to take down his imagined cult of Diabolos and their goal of resurrecting an ancient evil. Unfortunately, the cult of Diabolos is realer than Sid would have ever thought. Now, here's an isekai that I didn't feature before. The evidence in Shadow looks to be an interesting tale that looks to combine some elements of the faction-building formula and good old over-the-top Chunibyo. It may seem a little bit whack at first, but I think that it could end up being a sleeper hit of the season thanks to its very charismatic lead.
Oh no.
Don't let the cover art fool you on this one. I myself got tricked into thinking this is one of those coming-of-age dramas, and I couldn't be more wrong. So, what is Summertime Render then? What if I told you it's a Shonen Jump series that's quite darker than the usual Shonen fare and plays around with the idea of time loops? Are you surprised? I mean, I sure was. Shinpei Ajiro doesn't have what I'd call an extraordinary life. Things change when one of the Gofune sisters he used to live with, Ushio, dies in a supposed drowning. However, upon seeing the bruises on the body of the sister, as well as getting a vision from Ushio herself, he knows that something was amiss. Shifting shadows creep along the island, and it would take a monumental strength to save everyone. With Mio and others, Shinpei looks to find a future where his friends and family survive. A tall task, I'd say, with the happy ending seemingly slipping further and further away against an enemy smarter than it seems. If you're into mystery thrillers that soon end up giving you a lot of fighting and action, you should add this to your plan to watch list. With its emphasis on time loops and such, I'm sure the fans of ReZero and Edge of Tomorrow will have something to enjoy here.
Well, it might be pretty good.
The special sector, Far East Special District, more commonly known as 24th Ward. There, three childhood friends grew up together in spite of their differences, but their relationship changes in the wake of an incident. A year later, their phones all ring simultaneously. It's a call from a longtime friend who supposedly died, and the phone call leaves them with one instruction: choose the future. Reunited under a new mission, the three seek to protect the 24th Ward and all they hold dear, but will they be able to overcome their differences and save everyone? Original anime from Cloverworks, here we go. Is it just me, or does Tokyo 24th Ward somehow give off Anohana vibes? That or Wonder Egg Priority? However, this time I can see this turning into more of an action thriller that could be a sleeper hit of the season. January just can't come soon enough. And number 7 we have Requiem of Rose King. Historical drama never goes out of flavor, especially something with such a dark and noir atmosphere like this. Requiem of Rose King is a series loosely based on Shakespearean works Henry VI and Richard III. Born a cursed noble, Richard grapples against self-identity. Possessing both male and female characteristics, he immediately finds himself the object of scorn. Despite being loved by his father, the complete opposite can be said of his mother, leading him to a childhood of hatred. As he grows up, Richard starts to believe that he can find salvation by leading his father to the throne.
Well, this is going to be talked about in conventions.
Featuring no less than Jeanne d'Arc herself. With the War of Roses in full swing, will Richard bring his family to glory? Or will he drag it down the depths of the abyss? As Vanitas has shown us so far, dark fantasy will always have its fair share of fans. For those who are into classic literature or just enjoy dramatic shows with some supernatural drama written all over it, then this is something worth looking at.
This might be an example.
My own swords.
Different groups were used in conventions.
I remember back then, people were saying things like, if you haven't read Uzumaki, you haven't experienced Japanese horror yet. Now, while I wonder if such claims could still be justified now, almost a decade after that hype, one thing is for sure. Uzumaki is one of the most notable horror manga I've ever read, and it's very due for an anime adaptation, one that we'll be getting in the fall of 2022. The premise is simple, actually. It's a story about bizarre events involving spirals, and one that, as expected, slowly escalates. An obsession with the shapers, but the prelude to an entire town's spiral into madness. Having experienced the story in manga form, I think that one of the biggest selling points for Uzumaki is the art. Junji Ito is a master of horror, and it clearly shows with how disturbing and spine-chilling the illustrations are. With a relatively short story compared to the typical manga series and a confirmed episode count of just 4, Uzumaki looks to be one of those short but powerful types of anime. I'm expecting theatrical quality that more than amplifies the horrors that Junji Ito is capable of creating.
Definitely putting this on my list.
It's an original anime.
I did a reaction on the trailer
on Netflix,
already,
but first
haven't seen it.
When was the last time you saw an anime project generate so much hype doing so little? Well, it's not blowing up the internet viral, but the moment the trailer hit, I've seen some excited chattering related to Bubble. Then again, who can blame them? Urobuchi, Sawano, and Araki all involved. That's quite the all-star lineup you've got there, bringing together some of the people involved in beloved anime masterpieces like Attack on Titan, Psycho Pass, Fate Zero, and more. And it's by Wit to boot. There is a lot to be excited about. The parkour scene looks nothing short of awesome, and it seems that this is a movie that will bring
the
feels.
Certainly a welcome hardcore parkour. I think that's what I call the video. I call my reaction hardcore parkour.
Fourth is Hell's Paradise. For someone who's tired of this world, all of the killing and betrayal, what greater curse could there be than immortality? Betrayed ninja Gabimaru the Hollow thought he'd accepted his fate, yet death refuses to take a hold of him, owning to his subconscious desire to live and return to his wife. In exchange, Executioner Asaimon
is this his ninjutsu?
Proposal. To gain pardon, he's to join an expedition to an island south of Japan. The mythical elixir of life is said to be on that island, and it's the key to the ninja's freedom. However, dangers far greater than any man have seen lurk on that island. Will Gabimaru and his ragtag crew of criminals survive and grasp freedom? The premise is quite interesting, and I found myself picking the manga up and reading quite a bit of it. What I like the most about this story is that it's not just a simple good and evil type of action story. It goes beyond that with characters that may not be as bad as their reputation say. Come in for the action and adventure, get amazed by the good characterization. Sums up my experience reading it, so I can't wait to see it get animated. In third place, we have Blue Lock. 世界一のエゴイストでなければ世界一のストライカーにはなれない。
It's about time
we've got another one of those gritty sports anime, and Blue Lock's there to fill that void. The titular Blue Lock's a prison-like facility built with a sole purpose: to find Japan's next national team striker. From a pool of hundreds of participants,
football,
only one will get chosen, and the rest get banned from joining the team forever. One of the prospects is Yoichi, a striker dealing with doubts, further pushed by an unselfish...
They tend to do sports animes tend to do pretty well.
Project as an opportunity to clear his mind.
That big into sports animes, I've tried a few different ones. I just couldn't get into them.
And teamwork themes of typical sports anime and turns those conventions upside down. Oh, and their superpowers too. Reality just doesn't work that way. So the series instead delves on a more cynical take, going with the themes of ego and selfishness. Certainly a different take from what we used to see. And while I don't automatically equate cynical and dark to good, the series has a lot to keep you entertained. The characters end up being interesting and hard to predict, and it's up to you to decide how you look at them considering their circumstances. You rarely see psychological and sports combined as a genre, but if you want to see one done beautifully, then Blue Lock is your pick. Our second most anticipated anime this 2022 is Spy Family.
I did a reaction on this as well. On the trailer.
How could I have forgotten about this before? Even before it became an anime, Spy Family is a perennial favourite. I've seen a lot of people talk about it, so imagine the collective shouts of joy when an anime was finally announced. For the sake of world peace, there's no hurdle Twilight won't take. However, that statement just had to be put to the test with his latest assignment. You see, to investigate the politician Donovan Desmond, he gets tasked with infiltrating said stunt school. But how does one do that?
I was like, I wouldn't mind watching that one.
Have a child. And play family. Twilight now taking the alias Lloyd Forger.
I'm most likely to put this
family,
on my list.
But it turns out that the rest of his adapted family have their own hidden natures. A secret agent, an assassin, and a kid who can read minds. What happens when they come together, working towards their agendas while pretending to be an ordinary loving family? Now, this is a comedy I can get behind. I love how it intertwines action with comedy thanks to the absurd setup and scenarios that can quickly turn into thrilling sequences. If you enjoy those Mr. and Mrs. Smith type stories, this could be the anime for you. It's also got a slew of wholesome and relatable...
Wasn't there an animal or something like that with them as well?
That's always a bonus.
Might be wrong. Well, I remember seeing that in the trailer.
Coming up on top is Chainsaw Man.
Oh, yeah. I did a reaction on the trailer for this.
Everyone just can't get enough of Chainsaw Man, and its announcement is probably one of the major events this past few months. People went wild for this upcoming show, and as early as now, I'm calling this the mainstream hit of its season. Now, for the uninitiated, here's what it's all about. Chainsaw Man stars Denji. Having outlived his usefulness, he finds himself betrayed and slain by the same devils who are in cahoots with the Yakuza. Fusing with his pet devil, he gets reincarnated as the titular Chainsaw Man, swearing revenge on those who betrayed him. He joins the Public Safety Bureau as one of the hunters. Bloody, brutal, chaotic. That sums up Chainsaw Man. It's also extremely dark in comparison to most Shonen Jump titles, and it will surely be a great addition to its list of more cynical series like Death Note and the mentioned Summertime Render. However, talking about it just doesn't do it justice, so make sure that you watch it when it comes out.
It definitely will. Chainsaw Man seemed like it might be pretty interesting. Alright, so that was ViniiTube's top 10 most anticipated new anime of 2022. I think anime is just getting better and better, even with the ones that's coming out. Like, I know Bleach was announced, and they still got the next part for... I think they have the next part for Attack on Titan coming out, right? So they have a lot of stuff that's coming back. They have a lot of new stuff. I still have a lot of stuff from this year that I have to watch. But, I was like, we're trying to get through it. Yeah, it's a lot of good shows, a lot of different animes I would check out just to see if I like them or not. But yeah, I always try to give things, a shot. Even like the big ones, it's some that I haven't gotten to yet, but still on my list just because, stay busy. Having a wide variety of... of different things I geek out on, it's tough keeping up with everything, but I definitely try. But yeah, who knows y'all are looking forward to as far as 2022, what series and stuff y'all are wanting to see. Even the ones that are the continuations, like the next seasons and stuff like that. But yeah. ViniiTube will be also in the descriptions below again, so check them out. Check out some more stuff from them. But if you like this video, please put a like on the video. Please subscribe to some more of my content. Please do. Thank you all so much for jumping on and giving me a try. I appreciate it. Please take care of yourselves and each other. Peace, geekdom.